I have had a training in both computer science and computational biology. I'm specialized in machine learning and artificial intelligence algorithm development and their applications in biomedicine. The School of Computing at Queen's has a group of very supportive people, so I feel fortunate to be able to work with them here. Queen's University has its very unique culture, central location, and the reputation, which attract highly motivated undergraduate and graduate students. So I have the opportunities to work with outstanding students here. In addition, the School of Computing is going through an expansion phase right now, and it will be an amazing experience being part of this exciting transition. I am interested in designing next generation machine learning and AI algorithms that are more interpretable and transparent for applications in biomedicine. So machine learning has become a standard in many application areas, for instance, commerce or finance, but it has not seen wide applications in biomedicine. Part of the reason is that many powerful machine learning algorithms fail to provide explanations on why and how a decision has been made. So when you think about it, this is really critical for biomedical application because we need to understand the mechanism underneath the decision making and the consequence of failed or biased decision making can be really fatal in biomedicine. So this is what really keeps me stay up late at night. I want to advance machine learning algorithm design and to enhance their applications in biomedicine. So right now, it's a really exciting era for AI and machine learning research. In the next 10 years, I think AI will see a wider spectrum of algorithms specialized for different application problems. I think for a more reliable and transparent AI machine learning application, we need to have close collaborations between algorithm experts and the domain experts. For biomedical computing, as more intelligent and interpretable machine learning algorithms are being designed and incorporated into biomedical research, we will have more powerful tools to help us understand what, for instance, what genes and environmental factors are causing cancer or other complex diseases. So the near future of medicine will see a major revolution as well. So for my PhD, I was trained in computer science. Since then, I have been specialized in a very interesting AI technique called evolutionary computing. It's a type of algorithm inspired by natural evolution and is often used to solve very difficult problems through the evolutionary process. During my postdoctoral training, I learned about bioinformatics and biomedical computing. So this really describes how my research changed over time. It's from more theoretical algorithm design to more empirical biomedical applications. I think it's really important to be able to understand how an algorithm works and how to design your customized algorithm to solve a specific application problem. At the same time, working on finding a cure and early prevention to cancer and other human complex diseases is really rewarding and exciting. I think the most important quality is to be really passionate about science and research and to be able to work really hard on it. You need to really enjoy learning new skills and solving problems and make this your lifelong career. Another quality is good self-management in terms of both time and emotion. A typical day of a graduate student is often not very well structured, so you need to have good plans and to be more efficient. At the same time, research can be a very lonely process. You often have self-doubts, so it is also important to be persistent and to be able to make through. Thank you. computing has become so ubiquitous and it will increase its presence in our daily lives. Think about the devices and the services you have been using after you wake up every day that are coded or programmed by someone. So you may also want to know how it works and be part of that. After you learn computing, you will find that it's very different from any other disciplines that you studied before, and you will know that it is the most powerful tool to change the world and change the future. Again, it is about the power computing has to push forward science and technology and to make the world a better place. Computing is able to realize ideas and to advance the knowledge discovery process for many other disciplines. And also, when you look at superhero movies, you see there's always a computing sidekick, a guy or a girl in the chair who makes up the superhero's team. So this is an example to show you how popular and how important computing has become. I like traveling so I can learn about other culture, to know more people, to learn new things. In addition to that, I really like reading stories or watching movies that tell a good story. You never realize this, but a good storytelling ability is really important for being a scientist. You need to be able to tell your story in an interesting and intriguing way so other people can understand your research, can get excited too. I have two very young boys and they are pretty much my hobbies right now. But it's very fascinating to watch them learn and see the world through their eyes. I think there might be inspirations for AI research by looking at little kids and see how they learn different skills and how they gain human intelligence.